Well, let us start. My name is Alex Kapranoff. I'm from Moscow, Russia. I will tell you, well, I feel strange because last time I was talking about a product my friend asked me to tell about, that was Nginx. And his author, Igor, wasn't able to attend the auction, and he asked me to tell about his product. This time, it's completely the same situation. This is a tool that a friend of mine developed during his work at Yandex, and I use it, I love it. And he is, well, he is not yet eligible to receive his international passport because he is trying to run away from Russia, from serving in the Russian army. So I was asked to come here, and it looks like a marketing talk, because it is. I will advertise Ubic. We call it Ubic or Ubic. It's a personal service manager. We use a lot at the Yandex and in many other companies. So there is a blog post in which Slava, the author of Ubic, asked which tools I used to control services on in production, which tools I use to demonize, to watch the demons and the like. So this is the short list of answers that we got to that point. I suppose many of you guys used at least some of these tools. And Ubic is actually solving the same problem, well, in Perl. They've answered that he just, well, writes init.d scripts. This is script. You can see that he uses, well, kappa-based a lot. He has all his scripts, commands, and commands about mention to daemons. This is the second page of the same script. You can see a lot of boilerplate code, which is copied from one script to the next one. This is the same service described in Ubic language. So actually the interesting part is this. This is the only lines you need to actually create a service that will run as a daemon, that will be watched by a dedicated watchdog. This part has some logic that you can add to your service scripts. This logic was directly copied from here. Ubic tries to comply to Linux standard base specification. It supports all these standard commands. So the Ubic maybe and it is successfully used as a tool to write those init.d scripts, and I'll show you a bit later how short they might be. It has a script called naturally Ubic, which may be used to analyze the state of the services on the box. For example, here we can see a broken service that is not starting, and we can also see disabled service, which was manually stopped, and it won't be restarted by a watchdog. This is a system service that is distributed with Ubic. It may be switched off, but it's very small and useful because it allows to read the state programmatically. So these are just some examples of using Ubic script to stop start services, to restart ignoble services, because there is one level of hierarchy, so you can actually group services and then restart them for the group. Try restart is a Linux standard based command that restarts a non-disabled service and does not try to enable it as compared to the simple restart. This is the HTTP programmatic interface that is provided by the Ubic theme system service. Ubic Watchdog is a very simple script that should be run. It is usually run from cron once a minute. It just checks all this, the state of all the services, and once tries to run those that are not running but are not disabled. So you can also write your own services. This is the skeleton of a simple Ubic service. You need to provide start, stop, and status logic. Each service that uses Ubic service module should also do some checks inside start and stop. And as it sometimes gets a little bit complicated, there is also a Ubic service common, which just already have all the components of paid code. And it is a bit easier to create new services using Ubic service common. You just provide callbacks. There is also an even simpler way to create good behaving daemons by using Ubic service simple daemon. This is very easy to do. You provide your binary, three logs. And there are some more complicated parameters. There is also a very generic demonizer. There are several of them on CPAN, but we like this one. It is really tested in some very strange cases. It is used throughout the end of server structures in several data sets. We are recommending you to at least look at the demon when you are demon needs. There is also a way to if you have a lot of services that have much in common, you can factor out the logic and write your own skeletons for your services. This is the description of a service. It really consists of only two lines of code. My service was created here. And this is just all here. I've bit about multi-services, which are groups of services. They are created using directory hierarchy inside slash /etc slash Ubic directory. There are also other ways to create multi-services. This is the way to actually run Ubic services as part of Linux LSD stub process. This is two lines which actually run a service. You would run a special module that checks $0 to get which service to run. So if you just copy the same file in different names and you run those services from the beginning. There is some infrastructure to do testing how those service creates. We have some very complicated hierarchies of services running several Yandex products. So we actually invested time in testing in very confusing situations. Windows compatibility is not implemented, and maybe it's a feature. But it is actually used as many Linux boxes and previous boxes. It's installable from CPM, and Ubic admin, who may create the page of this simple script, is used to set up some permissions. And most of our Debian or Ubuntu hosts just install the Ubic from this API. There are several service skeletons already written for Flag servers and for running MPSP instances. You can easily run write such skeletons for your own services. There are also ideas to implement services that use other daemonizing modules from CPAM. There is no actual need inside the company for that. So maybe some of you guys need to do that. Oh, this is the main slide of this presentation. Since it's a marketing presentation, you can join the development. You can just use your link as it is. You can also talk to the development team using, different that's it. I can answer some questions.
With the logging examples that you showed where you get log files to write to the things, what for rotating those log files? So I don't want to be able to run a problem where someone writes a full new service and just logs and doesn't bother to rotate until it just pulls around.
There is no rotation alternative.
And how easy would it be to build a plugin that would add that rotation functionality, for example? That is, how extensible is Ubic 2?
It is an interesting question, and it's not interesting because, I don't know if it's easy or not, but I don't think it's a good idea to write the rotation directly into Ubic. Maybe it is much more flexible to rotate logs using external tools.
How do you make sure the Ubic makes it closes the file when you?
This is the point where any retaining tool should synchronize its partner with the actual tool.